Hello, everybody. This is a bit of biology by Mr. Rock. Today we're going to be talking about organelles, which play a huge role in cells and play a huge part in biology. So starting off, it's always good to define things before we jump into things. So first, we want to define what organelles are, and what they essentially are tiny structures that perform a specific function within a cell. So when you think of the word organ, some organs you think of right away might be liver, brain, heart. These are all bigger organs made up of a lot of cells to perform a specific function. And that's what organs are defined by, is their function. So organelles, the ending L just means tiny. So these are just tiny organs, and these are going to be found within cells, and they are designed to perform a specific function. So I don't have all the organelles here in this little image, but we have a nucleus that contains the DNA. We have ribosomes that make protein. We have mitochondria that make energy. We have ER that package proteins. Well, they fold proteins for us. We have a cell membrane. So we have a bunch of organelles that perform specific functions. So we're going to talk about each of these today. The one that everybody thinks is the most important is the nucleus. One thing that I want to start off with saying is that this organelle is only found in eukaryotes. It's only found in eukaryotes, so plant and animal cells. It is not found in prokaryotic cells, but it is only a protective container for the cell's genetic material. And what this means, genetic material, that's just fancy jargon for DNA. So the nucleus is the container for the DNA. Prokaryotes have DNA. They have DNA in their cells, but it just doesn't have a protective container called the nucleus. So eukaryotes have a nucleus. We're going to use a couple analogies today because that sometimes helps in understanding things. Nucleus would act as the command center. And here in my image, that I drew on the bottom right, that is a nucleus. There's only one nucleus per cell. Up next, we have the endoplasmic reticulum. That is a bigger word. So typically biologists just use the abbreviation ER. There are two different types of ER. There is the rough and the smooth ER. We call the rough ER because there are ribosomes on it. And the function of the rough ER is to fold and finish proteins made by ribosomes. So it makes sense that ribosomes are on it. And then the smooth ER makes the lipids for cell membrane. We are only going to find this in eukaryotes. So once again, plants and animal cells. And this is going to act as the analogy that I'm going to use is a highway system because it allows lipids and proteins to transport all throughout the cell. So a highway system is a good way to think of the ER. Ribosomes, I'm a huge fan of ribosomes because every single cell needs ribosomes to work. So prokaryotic, eukaryotic, all cells need ribosomes. What they do is they make proteins for the whole cell. It essentially carries out the DNA's instructions. If you're wondering what's the big deal about proteins, well, pretty much any organelle that we're talking about here is in some way made up of proteins. Lysosomes are solely made up of proteins. The cell membrane is made up of proteins. There's so many organelles where proteins is an essential role in their structure. So ribosomes are the ones that are doing all of this work. For this reason, I consider them the construction workers. In my image here that I have at the bottom right, I just want to let you know about this. They are all over the cell. So there's a lot of these, there's thousands of them in every single cell, and they're constantly making proteins. The Golgi apparatus is only found in eukaryotic cells. So this is only plant and animals, once again. When you see an image of the Golgi apparatus, typically it's on towards the outside of the cell. So if you look at my bottom left image here, it's towards the end of the cell and it looks very similar to the ER. The reason why it's towards the edge of the cell most times is because the Golgi apparatus acts as a post office. And what that means is it's going to package the proteins, the material that's coming in from the ER, it's going to package them and send them to their destination. So this destination could be outside of the cell, it could also be within the cell, but it acts as a post office for proteins. And like I said, proteins pretty much make up everything, and those proteins are made up of ribosomes. Mitochondria, the mighty mitochondria. This is the meme, it's the powerhouse of the cell, obviously. What does that actually mean? Before we actually start diving into the function, I want to address where it's found. So it is found in all eukaryotic cells, once again, plants and animals. And the big thing I want to emphasize here, it is in plant cells. A lot of people think that the mitochondria are just in animal cells, and that is not true. They are also in plant cells. What the function is it does cellular respiration. What does that mean? Cellular respiration is converting chemical energy, which is our food, and it converts it into cellular energy, which is ATP. So top right, that's what a mitochondrion would actually look like. And then in the bottom right hand image, I just wanted to show you that there are a lot of mitochondria in a cell, and your amount of mitochondria can actually increase based off of how much you work out. So if you're a very fit person, you probably have a lot of mitochondria in your muscle cells. Anybody who knows me knows that I'm going to make an argument for chloroplasts over mitochondria, and it's not just because I'm on that plant-based diet. I love chloroplasts, and the reason why is because the chloroplast is not going to be able, the mitochondria is not going to be able to do what it does without the chloroplast. So I'm going to jump back just real quick. It says the function of the mitochondria is to convert chemical energy into cellular energy. When we look at the function of the chloroplast, what it does is it converts sunlight energy into chemical energy, which is our food. So in order for the mitochondria to actually even work or function, it needs to have chloroplast. It needs to have something that's creating the food. So animal cells, we do not have chloroplasts. This is only found in plant cells. My analogy for this, better power plants, that's not supposed to be a pun. I don't know. It's an important organelle that is going to help out plants to make food for not only themselves, but for us. Cytoskeleton and cytoplasm. This is found in all of our cells, and the cytoskeleton, it acts as a skeleton in the cell. What that means is it's made up of proteins. Once again, going back to ribosomes, cytoskeleton is made up of proteins. So it's made up of proteins, and what it does, it holds the organelles in place. What the cytoplasm then does, it is a fluid, and it is within the cell. It's in between the cytoskeleton. It's a fluid that is within the cell, in between the cytoskeleton. So when I point to my images down here at the bottom right-hand side, it's not pointing to anything because it's all of the space that isn't the organelle. So all of the space in between the organelles, that's the cytoplasm, that's the cytoskeleton. Cytoskeleton is the protein fibers that add support. Cytoplasm is the fluid. My analogy here is this acts as the infrastructure, the cement of the city. We're coming up on the last couple here, and we're going to talk about the cell membrane. This is also a crucial organelle because it's found in all cells. That's prokaryotic and eukaryotic. The function is to act as a protective barrier that surrounds the whole cell, and it regulates what comes in and what goes out. My analogy for this is the border patrol, because essentially it is the border patrol for the cell. Because if you want to enter the cell or you want to exit the cell, you need to go through the cell membrane no matter what direction you want to go. The cell wall is often confused with the cell membrane. It is not the same thing. So first, I want to say that this is only found in plants and prokaryotic cells. The function is, it acts as more support, more protection for the cell itself. So the plant cell, if you look at the bottom image in the right, the cell wall is actually beyond the cell membrane. So the cell wall comes first if you're like going into the cell, and then next you would encounter the cell membrane. So it acts as more protection, more support for the cell. My analogy for this, it acts as a huge wall around the city. The lysosomes, these are usually forgotten about, not cared for, but they have a very, very important role to the cell. So they're found in eukaryotic cells, so plant and animals. And what is happening in the cell all the time is things are constantly dying and nutrients are coming in. So when organelles die, which they do, you need something to break that dead stuff down. Nutrients come in and you have to break those nutrients down. So lysosomes are just enzymes that break down the nutrients, break down the dead things within the cells so that we can reuse them again. For this reason, my analogy here would be a recycling center, because the lysosomes break down dead things, break down nutrients, and allow the cell to reuse those dead things. It's a great organelle. Finally, we have the vacuoles. The vacuoles are found in eukaryotic cells, so plants and animals. The main function here, I want you to think of it as a grocery store. So it contains water and food for the cell. The big takeaway would be that vacuoles are much bigger in the plant cell than the animal cell. This was Organelles. This was a bit of bio with Mr. Rock. I'm signing off. Have a great day.